I'm indeed very delighted and very humbled, and very often as we perform our daily roles and as we go about performing the many duties that we have to as a mother, as a daughter, as a child, we actually neglect our own health. And today we are just not great homemakers, but we also actually contribute to the economic growth of our families and of the country as a whole. And in all of that, we tend to neglect and ignore our health, our fitness. And you know, what is key, and we keep forgetting the fact that healthy lifestyles and a great fit body and mind is required for any professional or personal growth. And therefore, we are very happy to associate with Pinkathon for the fourth year now, actually. Because as a brand, and I look after Colors, my company, we are in the media business. And as Colors, through our compelling content, our stories, our stimulating characters, we've always inspired women to, you know, break the shackles, to chase their dreams. We've always stood for women empowerment. And therefore, we're really very happy to partner with Pinkathon in order to, you know, change mindsets of our viewers and help them to opt for better, healthier lifestyles and have a better future. And from there comes the whole fact about, you know, I really want to thank Milind and Reena, who, you know, lead this initiative, where they inspire women to actually, you know, make a difference, focus on their health, adopt a healthy lifestyle, and become brand ambassadors for other women and to promote health and fitness among the others. So an initiative that, you know, the inspiring stories and the response that we get brings us back year after year for the fourth year now. And I'm very happy to be part of this, and I'd like to salute every woman that participates here and takes part and supports this cause. And we are here to support you, to partner with you, and hope that we are able to actually inspire women out there to lead a healthy lifestyle, to keep their mind and body as fit as ever. That Sadhguru's taught me, and I spend about 45 minutes every morning, 20 minutes, 25 minutes of that is yoga, and then I do the Sukha Kriya every morning, and that really rears me up for the day.
Fantastic. So it's great. You spend a lot of time on yourself, but the message of Pinkathon actually is very, very simple. It's not really about running at all. It's just that we feel, and maybe because I'm a runner, and I know that running for me is the most convenient and fun tool towards a fitter lifestyle. But the message of Pinkathon is about just taking out time for yourself to do something that you love to do, something that you enjoy to do, but most importantly, to focus on your body, on your mind, on your emotions, to understand and accept them better, so that you can deal with your life more positively. And when we talk about disease, of course, we've been speaking about breast cancer for a long time, but truly any disease, if we deal with it positively, we deal with it better. So that is the very simple message of Pinkathon, and that's the message that has been picked up all over the country, and not only all over the country, but even in other countries as well. I don't know if many of you know, we celebrated
Pinkathon. As a good trainer, Priyanka, from last year. Priyanka is a good trainer for me. What an excellent trainer she is. I don't have words to express about her training. She always gives attendance of my training. 100% she gives, she keeps focus on my training and all my requirements while my training. She takes me for further run. And bigger part of Priyanka is she had sacrificed her own organization, it had given me second chance of mascot. And I also like to say thank you to other helping hands, to VIs. Thank you.
Thank you so much. And I must say that the participation from the visually impaired has grown in every edition over the years. So thank you, Deepthi, for coming. You're definitely going to be inspiring hundreds and hundreds of other women to run like you. Thank you so much. Our next speaker is RJ Palak, who is from Radio City, our new radio partners. And I must say that they are really doing an amazing job to support the Pinkathon and spread the message of Pinkathon. We haven't yet discussed how much Palak is going to run. She said five.
If you were standing on the finish line, I might
run. I am. That's why I'm going to be there at the finish line. And you're going to run. But you can run 10, right?
Actually, I just lost 18 kgs, so I have done my share of workout, but... Yeah, I hope so. As I said, if you are on the finish line, I'm definitely running. I'm running faster.
Super.
Push me first and then you can
catch me. But you know, because there are so many fans on the videos, when you tell them about your journey, and we need to do that.
And also, I don't know if it happens to you guys, but whenever we have a personal setback in our lives, whatever it is, relationship or job, we tend to eat, and I don't know how we put on weight. Like, I was not even eating that much, I had a personal setback, and I gained, like, suddenly, I blink of my eye, I was like 20 kgs heavier, and cold kapda pura nahi aa raha tha, and I had to take the whole wardrobe, and I decided, nahi ho payega. And of course, we have to be fitter, so let's start here. I want every one of you to please stand up right now. रेडियो वाले हैं तो थोड़ा सा करवाएंगे आपसे एंटरटेनमेंट. प्लीज प्लीज स्टैंड अप एवरीवन. प्लीज प्लीज. ओके सो वी वांट टू छोटा सा जॉब. थैंक यू सो मच. एंड मुझे लग रहा है हम इतनी लाइफ में इतनी बार बार करते हैं इसलिए एक साथ
वी कॉलेज टिल द टाइम इज स्टेलिंग आवर जॉब्स. The average weight we know that people put on is
so much, and This happens to everybody, irrespective of where they come from, who they are, what their background is. And we need to do something to reconnect with ourselves. And for us, we believe that sports is a great way to do that, to become more aware of your body, to become more aware of your mind. And within sports, running is the easiest, because not only can you run anywhere you like, but it's also a community activity. So you can be together with people who believe in you, who motivate you and encourage you all the time. Our next speaker, so the reason we have our mascots from different communities is because we believe a health risk. So very happy that you're here today to tell us about the benefits of baby wearing. And we'll have a lot of baby wearing mothers with us on the 15th of December. In fact, we bring them on to stage to dance with their babies, to spread that message to everyone. For everyone who knows a woman who's had a baby or who's pregnant, to say that you don't need to neglect your health after you've given birth. You need to take your baby everywhere, and you need to do the things that you always want to do. So,
thank you, sir, for having me here today.
Yes.
So, well, baby wearing, being a mother, and breastfeeding, these are the three things that I'm here to advocate through Pinkathon. I'm a nutritionist and I have always been a fitness junkie. I've been practicing yoga since the last 10 years. And believe me, I did Shirsasana till the last day before I delivered my baby. So, well, we as women, we know that we neglect our health. We usually sideline ourselves after our husbands or families or now even the babies. So what baby wearing brings to us is, okay, you own your baby, you do your cooking, you wear your baby, you go for walks. You're not only bonding with your child, but you're also giving yourself the, you know, wee time that you need with the baby and get your chores done. So that's the beauty of baby wearing. As mothers, as urban mothers, we usually neglect the importance of breastfeeding. believe me, that's one tool that helps you keep fit, keeps your baby fit, and helps you lose weight. So through baby wearing, breastfeeding is an easy job. You can do it anywhere, everywhere, comfortably, discreetly, and most importantly, you are not keeping your child away from the nourishment that it deserves. So, please join me and help spread the message to young mothers. My child is 6 months old and, you can baby wear as young as day one. So please help me spread the message to the community, to any new mothers that you know, and ask them to join the run with us. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Dhani. Would like to join, please let them know that we also have a breastfeeding zone at the Pinkathon to make it easier. I'd now like to introduce a very, very special lady, a very close friend of mine. When I told her about the Pinkathon in 2012 that we were planning to do something like this, she said that, we must talk about breast cancer. And at that time, I had no clue about breast cancer at all. And in fact, even at that time, we weren't really talking so much about it. And I said, what is it? What's the issue with breast cancer? And she said, it's one of the biggest killers in our country and in the world. And nobody wants to talk about it. So I said, okay, so, what is your connection with it? And she said, I had breast cancer many years ago. And I said, you didn't tell me, you're such a close friend of mine. And she said, I didn't tell anyone. But after her experience, she decided that this is a story that needs to be told. There were thousands of women out there who need support and who need help. And she started the Women's Cancer Initiative with Tata Memorial Hospital. And she's been with us right from the beginning. She's here today, Devika Bhojwani. Thank you so much for coming. And please tell us your inspiring story.
It's always really special to me that not only does he want to do something for women, but he also thought that breast cancer was important enough. And in 2003, I had just gone through my breast cancer in 2000. Luckily, it was caught at a very early stage, and I had just finished my treatment. He's right, I didn't speak about it then. In those days, nobody spoke about breast cancer. Of course, you thought that breast cancer happens to women in the West, but it was happening here. And I was just very fortunate that when I was being treated, I had to go through radiation, and my doctor was a woman. She was also the director of the Tata Memorial Hospital. I remember waiting outside her clinic, for 6 months. I would go every day for my radiation. And I'd wait there, and the clinic would be crowded with other women waiting quietly, patient with their husbands, their families, their children. Never moaning, never looking, why me? I was the one who was trying to hide and, pretend I was just here with somebody else. But over the months, I noticed that the clinic was less crowded. The family members were not coming with these women, the husbands, the brothers, whoever. These women were just sitting there on their own. When I went in to get my treatment, I just brought this up with my doctor and I said, Doc, I'm noticing that the women are just sitting there on their own now. What's up? And she looked at me and she said, Devika, what can I tell you? In this country, when families hear that a woman has cancer, they abandon them. These women, a lot of them were coming with their family members in the beginning, and now they don't have the money to reach me, they don't have the money to take that bus and train, whatever, but they find their way to my clinic and they sit here and they say, help me, cure me, I want to be back to my family and my... And she says, I don't know what to do. It made me realize, and I realized, first of all, that everything happens for a reason. And I believe that somewhere I was put in that position that I had to do something. And I had the means, I had the contacts, I was already doing a lot of things for different social causes. And Dr. Dinshaw, who was the director of Tata Hospital, made me an offer. She said, Devika, come and partner with me. Let's set up a foundation. Let's do something for these women. They as much deserve. They also have their little families. They also need to go back. Eventually, we're all sisters under the skin. And if people like you don't come and do something, then where will we begin? That's when in 2003, we set up the foundation, Women's Cancer Initiative. And my dear friend, Milind Soman, when he came to me, a few years later and he said, let's do something. Let's talk about it on a much larger platform. Let's raise funds. You know, it was such a blessing in disguise. And today, I can tell you that nearly 500 women every year are being treated thanks to the Women's Cancer Initiative, thanks to events, platforms like the Pinkathon, who raise money through all the women who take part. Part of that money comes to us. These women, maybe they don't know your faces, but they feel hope. They feel support. They know they're getting help. So it's been an amazing journey. I'm just so pleased to be part of it. Every year we have more dynamic women sitting here. We have an amazing young lady here who has her story to tell. I've been following her quietly. In this day and age, to come out and be brave and talk about what you've gone through with your head held high is very special. So a great, great thank you to Pinkathon, to Milind, to the whole team, and to every woman who's part of it, because not just the ambassadors, but every girl who comes in, runs, and knows she's doing it, not just for herself, to empower herself, but along the way, she's empowering and helping so many women. Thank you once again for having me.
Thank you so much, Devika. As usual, your words inspire no end. Out for the Valini 10 kilometers. She's 81 years old. She's a shy 81-year-old, a barefoot sari runner, retired professor of biochemistry, started trekking at the age of 60, completed the 100-kilometer Oxfam trail walk in 41 hours. I haven't finished. She also walked more than 300 kilometers with me last year. This will be her 16th Pinkathon. Usha Soman.
I'll never say I can't do this. Unless you try, you will never know. I think each one of us has so much potential, only it is not tapped. You need to be pushed. There has to be somebody to tell you, okay, you try this. And if you try, you'll be surprised. You can do so many things. Like I did trekking at the age of 60. I didn't know I could trek. I didn't even know what was trekking. It's just that when I saw the pictures of Himalayas, I said, oh, it's so wonderful. Wish I could go there. And the travel agents, the touring agency said, oh, you can go. We will take you. And I was thrilled. So, and I did make it to base camp. Base camp was my second trek, actually. So it's nothing is impossible. But you have to try and give it your all, and you will succeed. That's all is my secret. So, and age is just a number to me. And to you, it should be the same to you, too. Don't say I'm too old for this and too old for that. You're never too old. Your mind should be young. So whatever you want, you try it and you will succeed, I assure you. It's my own experience. So thank you.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. What could not be here, the mascot of Pinkathon couldn't be here today. When we're talking about age, she's 104 years old. Started running at the age of 93, and she is now the world champion in her age group in the 100 and 200 meters and in the javelin throw and the shot put. She's not here today. Her name is Man Kaur. She's from Chandigarh, and she will definitely be there on the 15th of December to cheer all the women at the Pinkathon Mumbai. One thing that I wanted to talk about very specially is the medal that we give. So we try to make everything that we do at Pinkathon meaningful. It has to have a story behind it. And the medal of the Pinkathon that we give is a doll. So the women who have participated before have seen this doll, they know it. This doll is called the Tsunamika, and it was created. We all remember there was a tsunami across the east coast of India many years ago, and that destroyed many, many lives. And there was a group of women who lost everything. They lost their homes, they lost their livelihood. And the way they got back to being productive members of society was by making this doll. This doll is called the Sunamika, and this doll wears the Pinkerton Finishers medal. This doll itself is a symbol of empowerment. It's a symbol of hope. It is a symbol that there is no obstacle that you can face in life that you cannot overcome with strength. So all the women who participate in Pinkerton across the country are very proud to wear this medal. We had actually invited the creator, Uma Prajapati, here today, but unfortunately she couldn't be with us. But we're really, really proud to have this medal, the Sunamika, and we're very proud that women wear it at every Pinkerton. So one of the things that we do at every Pinkerton with our medical partner, and it's a great initiative, we offer a free medical checkup to all the participants, and we offer a free mammogram to all the women over 45. And the reason behind that is that, one, because we are talking about breast cancer, and breast cancer is one of the curable cancers, but if caught in the early stages. So it's very important that you go for regular screenings. It's very important that you're aware of any changes in your body, so that you could be, maybe if there's something that you feel is serious, you go and get it checked. So when we offer this checkup, it is sometimes the difference between life and death. So what we have seen, unfortunately, is we give this offer to all the participants, but the number of participants that actually take it up, and it's free, remember, these are expensive tests. Each test is about 5,000 or 6,000 rupees. Only 2% of the participants actually take the test. And which is even more of a concern is that they're allowed to give this test to whoever they want. They can donate this test, and they don't do that. That is how much or how little we are concerned about our own health, how much we want to ignore the possibility that something bad could happen. So in fact, we were told a couple of years ago that, you know, why are we giving this test? Nobody takes it. It's just a waste of time. It's a waste of space at the event. We have a stall. We take registrations. But the fact is, if we want things to change, we have to keep talking about them, even if nobody's listening. And that is also how the Pinkerton has grown. When we started the Pinkerton, people said that it's a woman's run, you know. Women are not going to come, they don't have time. When we went to Bangalore for the first time, which incidentally is our biggest city today, it has like a huge, really dynamic community of women runners. When we went there for the first time, they told us, do the event in the evening. Because in the morning, women are very, very busy, you know, they're making breakfast and they're doing puja and they're doing this and that. And they don't have time. Do it in the evening when they're a little free, and maybe they'll come for your run. And we had the biggest bigger than Bombay, the biggest participation of women in Bangalore in their first edition. So that just goes to show how much, as a society, we have these misconceptions about ourselves, and especially about our women. So we have to keep at it. We were not discouraged by the people talking about it. We thought that, okay, you're from Bangalore, you know best, but they didn't. We went to Delhi, we thought, you know best, but they didn't. But the women knew, and the women came. So even if today women think it's not important to do regular screenings, to understand more about themselves, the more we talk about it, the more the ambassadors spread the message, the more partners that we have, the easier and the better it's going to be. And again, when we talk about partners, I must tell you, when we try to get sponsorship for Pinkerton, a lot of the companies we went to said that, you know, we don't talk to women. Women don't decide what to buy, maybe except for sanitary pads and cosmetics. They're not decision makers for any kind of purchase. In fact, phone companies told us that women don't buy mobile phones. They said women only use secondhand phones. That is their research. You know, that's their research. Women don't buy phones. And so why would we talk to women? So I'm very, very grateful to all the partners that we have. They're amazing partners because it's not about the numbers, it's not about the women, it's about bringing change, it's about adding value to society, and it's about belief that if our country is to get healthier and fitter and greater, then the key to that is women. So again, big thank you to the partners, and a lot of the partners are here today. A big thank you to them. And a big thank you, yes, and a big thank you to our medical partner, Motherhood Hospitals. We have Dr. Isha Theba. Thank you.
Women and Child Healthcare Hospital. It is basically a Bangalore-based hospital network. We are committed to provide complete quality care to women, children, and newborns. We are having a 24/7 emergency services to handle all kind of gynecological complication and high-risk pregnancy cases. Related to breast cancer, early detection and awareness is very much important. Early detection means early provisional diagnosis. Early provisional diagnosis of the breast cancer, in which stage it can be treated easily, but it is most treatable. See, we have, as per the data, according to the statistics, we have a data, there are more than 2 lakhs cases of breast cancer in the last 6 months. So early detection and regular health checkups of women is very much important. We are having a different number of healthcare packages according to the age groups of the women. You can avail our services. It is there with us. We are having the different kind of women healthcare packages. We are having a WOW package in which we have included fetal scan, fetal medicine scans. We are having 24/7 medical services in our in-house. Our doctor medical fraternity is having more than 25 years of experience in their respective fields. The most important thing is in malignancy, in each and every case, early detection and early diagnosis of every disease is very much important. So go for regular health checkups. Women fitness is very much important because women is a pillar of the any building. If pillar is not strong, building will never be as strong. So we are provide, as a medical partner, it is our privilege to be a medical partner of Pinkathon. We are providing free 1 gynecological consultation along with a breast mammogram scan to all the Pinkathon participants. I would like to thank on the behalf of the Motherhood team for taking this great initiative to hold the Pinkathon team. I would like to congratulate for taking this great initiative. Thank you so much.
Thank you, doctors. She's a writer and a filmmaker. She wants to use her voice to spread awareness about women empowerment, self-love, and a wholesome lifestyle. She firmly believes that each one of us has the power to bring a positive change to the world and wants to encourage everyone to take charge of the change they want to bring in their lives into the world. Tahira Kashyap Khurana, thank you for coming.
To begin with, I'd never expected that it would happen to me. Like most of us, and like how you just said that we have this sort of a, we live in denial, and then we have this sort of a invincible thing about us that nothing can happen to us. I was pretty much in the same zone, in the same plane. And I had my symptoms. My breast started feeling heavy, and I sat over on my symptoms for over 2 months. In fact, I was rejoicing, honestly speaking. I've said this many times before, but it's the truth. I was like, yay, science bada ho. But having said that, there's a secretion that started coming, and then when I went to the doctor, what happened is what I happened. Like, I had stage 1A breast cancer. I had a mastectomy and I had a reconstruction. I had 12 sessions of chemotherapy. But there has been a big learning from this journey. The biggest learning is that to talk is like what you just said. And which is why I'm here today, which is why I just don't leave any platform, because I will keep talking. If somebody wants to judge me with the same lame jokes that I make, let them judge. Because had someone talked about it in my family or my family friend circle, I wouldn't have been sitting on my symptoms for 2 months. So it is very, very essential, very, very important. Like you said, we must talk. So many screenings are held, like you said. And I was really surprised to know that only 2% of the women, they just turn up. It is sad, but again, change, we all are the change makers. We need to do that. And yeah, when I decided, I once you're going through an ordeal, you don't just want to disclose it to the world because, you know, it's like, it's my problem. And this is somehow, there's a lot of intimacy attached to breast cancer because we have the word breast and so many people are obsessed, scared, but you can't, first of all, to say the word cancer only, it has been such a big taboo in my family and my family friend circle. Genuinely, honestly, in my 35 years, yes, last year I was 35 when I had, in my 35 years, I haven't heard my parents say the word cancer. Abhi aisa to hai nahi ki mere family mein nahi hoga, mere family friends mein nahi. They all came out once I shared with the world, this uncle of mine is calling, this aunt of mine is calling. And I was like, where were you all? I needed to hear the word cancer when I was a kid. There's nothing wrong in it. The idea is to be aware, to acknowledge. And so yeah, that was so then when I was in the hospital, again, how we all are brought up, a lot of my family members told me that this, you really don't need to talk about this to anyone. This will remain within the close confines of a family circle. And I was pretty much convinced about it also. But my treatment had me sit in the hospital for about like 7 to 8 days after the surgery and constantly going to and fro for procedures and everything. And that's when I sat with the doctors and I was very, very shocked to find when he said that a lot of men don't let their women go in for checkups because they are so obsessed with, I mean, so they don't encourage. So even if a woman sort of says that there's a symptom or two coming, they don't appreciate anybody touching their woman's breasts. I don't know what's so unique and precious about them, but and I was really, really appalled because this costs life. And then there were a lot of women who were very conscious. There was a lot of embarrassment, humiliation. India as a country, it's not a nuclear setup. We live in a joint family predominantly. Small towns still have those joint setups and women are really, really embarrassed to talk about to their family members, to their brother-in-law, mother-in-law, sister-in-law. They will sit on the symptoms, let the lump grow into something massive, but they will not speak to their family. How difficult is it to just talk, to express, and then just go for a checkup? So there have been all these, when all these facts and figures that were thrown at me, I thought that, like ma'am just said, that everything happens for a reason. So I intended to turn my karma, I would call it karma, I am a strong believer of that. I chant, I practice Nichiren's Buddhism, and I, with that perspective, I thought that this obstacle has not come to get me. I need to defeat it, and it, if it's come in my life, I'm going to turn my karma into my mission. So hence, I am here, and I'm talking to you all. Yeah, and when it comes to early detection, like the only reason, I feel one of the reasons we all are out here is also that this message of early breast cancer detection is on top of our minds. So, and which is why I'm also a part of it. And sadly, India in terms of statistics has the highest number of breast cancer cases amongst women, both in terms of incidence and mortality. With higher proportional prevalence in younger age group as compared to the global average. I don't know, the reason could be because we don't catch it at an early stage. 60% of the cases are diagnosed at an advanced stage. And if caught early, then it's just not a treatable disease, it's curable. So it's a very big learning for us, it's curable. So, but we need to catch it early. And yeah, that's what it is.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Breast cancer, you
yeah,
mean to say.
Right.
We will not say elements, we will not say big C, we will say cancer.
Okay, right.
I feel definitely healthy body is one thing. But I also feel that a body is not just existing in isolation. There's a big unison with your mental well-being. And I feel most of the health problems that we have, it's a manifestation of our own anxieties and our own stresses in life and our own negativities and our own thoughts. So I feel it's very, of course, it's important to purify your body, but it's equally important to purify your mind and your soul as well. Faith really helps you do that. Your own practice will help you do that. But you need to really, really... I thought all this is bullshit. Now I can say it's not a... because when my parents would tell me, or someone just be happy, try to be happy, have a lot of gratitude in your heart, I was in this rebellious mode. I was like, please, nothing, it doesn't matter. But I think few incidents in your life just sort of changes the way you sort of look at life, and I look at life through a different prism altogether. The perspective should always be, like ma'am said, never to be defeated. You have to make that into your core principle. And I want to quote my mentor, Mr. Daisaku Ikeda. He says, to do what I can is normal. To go beyond my ability is a challenge. And where my ability ends, my faith begins. You need to have faith in yourself that you will overcome whatever situation. And that's my tip. No food tips, no anything tips. Just be sorted in your head. So there are really funny ones, like there's a mole on my breast. Do I have breast cancer? I was like, so, but I just feel there are a lot of myths and everything. You know, like I said, science and doctors have their valid reason. Now, we need to understand that we still really don't know why breast cancer happens or any cancer happens, why it happens. Of course, doctors will give you the obvious reasons. There is obesity, there is alcoholism, there is drug abuse, there is late marriage and late kids. So they have pointed out all these and age. But there are few cases, and in fact many cases like me, when none of these, I don't fit the bill, the factors don't work for me, which is why I have my own conspiracy theory. You know, there are too many conspiracy theories going around. My conspiracy theory is to do with mental health and well-being. I feel where we are right now, it's a manifestation of our thoughts, actions and deeds that we did in our 15s and 20s. Your 40s or your 50s or your 60s will be a manifestation of what you do right now. I was a very negative person 3 years back. I was on the other end of the spectrum completely. There was no gratitude in my heart. There was regret, and I used to begrudge a lot. I'm genuinely telling this to anyone, and I'm sure nobody will judge, because most of us have been there in that position at some point of life or the other. And I know that whatever has happened has been a manifestation of all that. Henceforth, I have decided that my life, I'm just going to be, my heart should be full of gratitude. And there is really, all of us have enough reasons to be grateful about. So, why am I starting this like a lecture? Sorry. Yes. Yeah, so I think this talk, honestly speaking, is more for men than women. They also need to know stuff about, and also very shocking to know that men are the decision makers in a family. But India as such, as a country and the world, is largely patriarchal. Of course, we are working towards a better direction, and events like Pinkathon is really helping us do that. But till that time, I think the men of the house should also be conscious, and they should know that these are the symptoms. If they emerge, I should encourage the women in my house and around my house to take them for an early breast cancer detection. Apart from that, also when it comes to fitness, after that, in fact, I was really fit, honestly speaking. I was, so even that factor, like the doctor said, obesity and all that. So even I was gymming every day on an everyday basis, and yet I had what I had. Is again, I'm going back to the same problem, that the root is somewhere else. We all need to figure out that root. We could have a 36, 24, 36 and yet have a screwed up head. It's going to lead you to a screwed up body eventually. So I feel we really need to, my only advice, or my only thing that I want to share, is that really be sorted in your heads. We are all born to be happy. We need to acknowledge that, and we need to be happy. That's it. And I don't know.
Yeah, even I was.
I know Milind Soman. He's a hot one here.
First for the 21 kilometer. I'd like to ask. All okay? Nina Elavia Jaipuria to present the first bib for the 20.
The 15th of December. Remember that we want to leave no woman behind. Whatever the age, from the youngest to the oldest, whoever you know, whether they've just had a baby, whether they're pregnant, cancer conquerors, visually impaired, to celebrate with us, because the Pinkathon is a celebration of health, and to take their first steps, hopefully, towards a fitter lifestyle. So thank you very much. Thank you very much to the media for being here. And I'd like them also to know that it's not just their words that we'd like to see in their publications, but also for their own families, we'd like to invite them to be there with us, to celebrate with us on the 15th of December. To the Women's Cancer Initiative, I'd like to ask Devika Bhojwani.
Your husband, your children, your immediate family members and your friends, so wo struggle utni zyada struggle nahi rehti. It just, the journey becomes easy, the journey becomes lovable, the journey becomes joyous. So all of us thrive on love. So I really wish that each one of us is surrounded by a lot of love.
You pointed out one thing ki husbands jo hai wo सामने नहीं आना चाहते हैं एंड यू नो बट टच विद यू हैड अ ग्रेट सपोर्ट ऑफ आयुष ही हैव ऑलवेज सपोर्टेड यू वी हैव सीन दैट बट आप दूसरे जो हस्बैंड्स हैं उनके लिए क्या कहना चाहेंगे.
I really wish every husband and every wife are there with each other through thick and thin. I was really surprised and shocked to know the fact that Milind just said that a lot of women, when they have cancer, and especially in a rural belt, the men of their house, they abandon the women. So that's I was really not just shocked but appalled. बहुत दुख होता है ये सुन के कि जब कोई बीमारी होती है तो आपके आस पास के लोग आपको छोड़ देते हैं. तो it is struggle सबकी life में होती है in some way or the other. Like I said, if you have the support of your people, if your family members, of your loved ones,
वो जर्नी थोड़ी और बेहतरीन हो जाती है, बिकम्स जॉयस. आई रियली विश दैट ऑल द मैन दे सपोर्ट देयर वुमेन एज मच एज माई हस्बैंड डिड एंड that's how it should be.
But besides Ayushman, was that one person who was with you always and who supported you the most?
So na kuch rishte hote hain jo aap jaise aap, it's my parents and my husband are there, but there are few relationships that you choose, and that's one person in my life. Her name is Komal and she is my best friend. I don't know, friend is a small term for her. This woman was with me throughout my treatment every day at the hospital. She was spending nights with me and my parents were taking care of my kids. It's unbelievable how much love we can give to each other in spite of the fact that you're not in blood relation or something. So that's how deeply connected we all are. It's very good to forge such relationships.
Okay, so recently Ayushman took one post on social media that was with you and without you. Just wanted to know your reaction when you just saw that, a picture and...
I prefer the one with me. Oh, definitely bahut zyada better picture
hai. Very true. Okay, lastly, kuch message in Chinese for the people who are suffering from cancer.
I just feel this message is not just for people who are suffering from breast cancer, but people at large, people in general, because once we start talking about an issue like this, we remove the stigma and the taboo which is associated with it. Also makes life easier for a whole lot of people who are going through it. So we need an attitude change, a change in perspective in the society at large, and it's not just targeted to people who are suffering. It's the world that makes us. So the world needs to change its perspective. And of course, we really need to talk about early breast cancer detection. If there is any symptom which comes up, your breast feels different, please go through a doctor and get yourself examined. And if the doctor tells you, please, after the age of 40, 45, get your annual mammograms done. Early breast cancer detection cannot just lead to treatment. I'm saying it's not just treatable, it's curable too.
But
so,
how much do you think that log ab baat karna chahte hain?
आई रियली विश, मैं चाहती हूँ भी और भी हमारे पास बहुत स्कोप है और भी बात करने का. मतलब हम अभी जितना हम बात कर रहे हैं, मैं चाहती हूँ उससे हम 10 गुना ज़्यादा बात करें. बात तब बनेगी जब छोटे घर से लेके बड़े घर की औरतों को उतनी ही सहूलियत मिले, उतना ही कंफर्टेबल मिले, नॉट इन टर्म्स ऑफ जस्ट फैसिलिटीज फ्रॉम द हॉस्पिटल बट फ्रॉम द फैमिली मेम्बर्स एट लार्ज. जब हम सब बात करना शुरू कर देंगे तो ये शायद इस डिसीज़ का जल्दी हमें डिटेक्ट हो जाए, एंड देन ऑफ कोर्स इट लीड्स टू लेस मोर्टैलिटी. India, and like I just said a while back, that the most common cancer in India is breast cancer, and both in terms of incidence and mortality. So we are losing a lot of lives just because it has been detected at an advanced stage. So yeah,
thank you so much.
Thank you.
पिंकथॉन में हर एडिशन में हर साल कुछ नया एडिशन होता है, एंड दैट इज़ अ लॉट टू डू. जो पार्टिसिपेंट्स होते हैं उनसे हमें बहुत सारे आइडियाज़ मिलते हैं, इंस्पिरेशन मिलता है. एक इवेंट जो हमने किया दिस संडे वाज द पिंकथॉन 100 किलोमीटर इवेंट, और हमने देखा कि बहुत सारी महिलाओं ने, और ये महिलाएँ स्पोर्ट्स वूमेन नहीं हैं, एथलीट्स नहीं हैं, जिन्होंने 3 किलोमीटर के साथ शुरुआत की थी पिंकथॉन में, फिर 5 किलोमीटर पे गए, 10 में गए, हाफ मैराथन पे गए 21 किलोमीटर, और फिर पूछने के लिए लगे कि इसके बाद हम क्या कर सकते हैं. और इसी मैसेज के साथ उन्होंने शुरू किया कि थोड़ा सा समय अपने लिए निकालो, 5 मिनट भी कम नहीं है. 5 मिनट अगर आप अपने सेहत के लिए निकाल सकते हो, देन इट इज़ अ गुड स्टार्ट. और इसी के साथ उन्होंने शुरुआत की, एंड टुडे थिंकिंग की पहले कि मेरे पास टाइम नहीं है, मेरे इतने सारे रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज़ हैं, मैं ये नहीं कर सकती, दे आर नाउ रनिंग 100 किलोमीटर्स. सो वी ऑल्सो रियलाइज दिस, और उन्हीं से हमें ये आइडियाज़ आते हैं कि वंस यू स्टार्ट समथिंग गुड, देर इज़ नो एंड टू वॉट यू कैन डू, नॉट ओनली फॉर योर सेल्फ बट एवरीबडी अराउंड यू. और हमारा मैसेज ये भी है कि हम यूथ के बारे में बात करते हैं कि यूथ को ये करना चाहिए, वो करना चाहिए, हमारे बच्चे आजकल कुछ नहीं करते, ये हम बहुत सुनते हैं, लेकिन हम कहते हैं सबसे कि आप करके दिखाओ उनको. सिर्फ कहना नहीं कि ये करना है, वो करना है, ये अच्छी चीज़ है, वो अच्छी चीज़ है, आप करके दिखाओ, वो आपको देख के सीखेंगे, तो बच्चे वही सीखेंगे जो हम उनको दिखाएंगे. एंड आई थिंक द वुमेन ऑफ पिंकाथन यही करते हैं, अपने एग्जांपल से वो पूरी दुनिया को इंस्पायर कर रहे हैं।
ओके, सो टॉकिंग अबाउट 2012 से लेके अब 2019 तक कितना ग्रोथ देखते हैं पिंकाथन के
अंदर? पिंकाथन में अभी हमारे 8 सिटीज़ हैं, 8 शहरों में हम पिंकाथन करते हैं, और हमने देखा है कि अभी बॉम्बे में, बैंगलोर में, दिल्ली में, वी हैव रीच्ड अ कैप 10,000 पार्टिसिपेंट्स इन दीज सिटीज़। हम 10,000 से ज़्यादा नहीं कर सकते क्योंकि वेन्यूज़ थोड़े छोटे हैं, रास्ते पर हमारी दिक्कतें आती हैं, तो वी कैप द लिमिटेड 10,000 पार्टिसिपेंट्स, और दूसरे शहरों में भी वी आर स्लोली गेटिंग बिगर एंड बिगर। बट द बिगेस्ट थिंग इज़ कि हमें बहुत सारे रिक्वेस्ट आते थे दूसरे शहरों से, छोटे छोटे टाउन से, गाँव से, कि हमारे यहाँ पिंकाथन क्यों नहीं है, हम क्यों नहीं पिंकाथन कर सकते। तो हम कहते थे कि करो, तुम भी पिंकाथन करो, इसमें कोई बात नहीं, या वुमेन्स रन करो, महिलाएं आएंगी, दौड़ेंगी। तो बोले ना, हमको पिंकाथन चाहिए। तो हमने कहा कि ठीक है, यू नॉमिनेट योर सिटी एंड योर टाउन ऑन आवर वेबसाइट एंड वी विल हेल्प यू कि ये इवेंट किस तरह से करते हैं, किस तरह से आप महिलाओं को आप इनक्रेज कर सकते हैं, मोटिवेट कर सकते हैं। एंड वी क्रिएटेड पिंकाथन डे, एंड पिंकाथन डे दिस ईयर वी सेलिब्रेटेड इन 10 countries। तो इतना बड़ा हुआ है कि 10 देशों में हमने वो इवेंट किया, एंड 176 लोकेशंस अक्रॉस दीज 10 countries। तो छोटे छोटे गांव, छोटे छोटे शहर, सब सारी जगहों में पिंकाथन डे सेलिब्रेट हुआ 20 अक्टूबर को, एंड वी सेंट मेडल्स एंड टी शर्ट्स फॉर द इवेंट, फॉर दैट सेलिब्रेशन अक्रॉस द वर्ल्ड टू ऑल ऑफ देम।
ओके, सो रिसेंटली पानीपत में 50,000 पार्टिसिपेंट्स ने यू नो पार्ट किया है, रजिस्टर किया है, सो कंग्रेचुलेशंस फॉर दैट।
बट दैट वाजंट आवर इवेंट, बट कंग्रेचुलेशंस टू देम एज वेल।
ओके, बट पिंकाथन का ही
था, उन्होंने नाम यूज किया था, लेकिन वो हमारा ऑर्गेनाइजेशन।
So
पिंकाथन एक्चुअली इज़ अ रजिस्टर्ड ट्रेडमार्क, एंड हमने उनसे उनको बताया कि यू नो अगर आप पिंकाथन करना चाहते हैं तो हमारे साथ जुड़ के कहो, लेकिन बाय द टाइम वी न्यू इट दैट ऑलरेडी डन द इवेंट। बट जस्ट टू सी कि द जो नाम है पिंकाथन का इतना पावरफुल हुआ है कि उस बैनर के नीचे इतनी सारी महिलाएँ जुड़ सकती हैं, दैट इज़ समथिंग दैट वी आर वेरी हैप्पी टू।
सो इसके अलावा यू नो फोमो शॉट सीजन 2 भी आने वाला है।
जी, कब है? यस आई एम देयर। व्हेन इज इट? yeah, I'm there in that, and there are a couple of other reality shows that I'm participating in, aur kuch films bhi hain, web series hain jo main jinke baad jinka main kya kar raha hu abhi zikr nahi, I'm checking it.
Okay.
To see whether I can do them.
I thought ki aap zikr nahi kar sakte.
Main ha zikr to nahi kar sakte kyunki I'm not decided to do it yet, but as soon as I do I'll let you.
Thank you.
Thank you.